Well, today I was reading the paper, University of Michigan's affirmative action thing, where they gave black students an extra 20 points on their application. So how did they come up with 20 points, first of all? Okay, what is it? You get a point for each time Rodney King got hit and divided by the amount of classes Chris Webber cut when he was getting B's and all this now? Let me just say one thing before we start. Usually I'm the one that puts out the obscure joke and bombs. This time I was begging everybody. Nobody's gonna remember Chris Webber played for Michigan. No, do it, they said. It'll get a nice laugh. And look what happened. Folks, let me tell you something. I practice affirmative action here at this show. Okay, look, today we got a Jew, an Italian, a black, and even a special needs person. We do it for the tax incentives. Should affirmative action be part of the college admissions process, John?
What?
We start off with you. You got that. Hey, you know, when you get the heat, you got to take the...
I was supposed to write some stuff? I think it's excellent. I think it's an excellent thing because you give the black student 20 points and we're even. Oh. Yes, we enslaved them for many years, but seriously, 20 points on the college application, that's a real bump.
We don't really want, we don't want your points.
What's that?
We don't want your points.
Thank you,
we want your 40 acres and your mule. That's what we want. Because that's what was promised to us in the Emancipation Proclamation.
See, I can't have a mule in my apartment, so I don't even have one.
We don't want the apartment. We want the 40 acres. We want the real estate. And I want my 40 acres right between Bel Air and Brentwood. Right in there, that's where I want my 40 acres.
The black and the Jew are taking it. It's like the landlord and the tenant. Now, let me get a word in here. I'm a little split on this because I'm against affirmative action on college campuses, but I do understand it because when I think back when I went to college, if I wasn't sitting next to like an Asian kid or an Indian kid on a test, I would have flunked out in 3 weeks.
Well, they said one of the a lot of the justices wouldn't comment, but Scalia and Rehnquist, who are known as the Nick DiPaolos of the court, actually said that Michigan made its standards too tough. And that's the problem. If they wanted to attract more minority students, either lower the standards or have more white girls on the brochure.
Yes. Let me ask you this. What were the standards when you got booted out of community college in Jersey 5 years ago?
That really hurt.
No, I know. Go ahead, what?
Listen, I don't think you guys understand, you know, what it's like for white kids today trying to get into college. And, you know, I don't think you know the heartbreak of losing out, not getting into Harvard because, you know, a black kid takes your place and you have to go to your safety school, Brown. I mean, that's heartbreaking for these kids. And, you know, it's the kind of pain that doesn't go away just because your parents send you to Europe for 3 months in the summer.
But what about the average?
It's true.
You know what?
You know, a lot of times those kids have to backpack.
That's true. The thing is that that's the point that they're missing, is that, first of all, they're not talking about normal white people. Those white people...
Why'd you look at him when you said normal white people?
I know.
Jesus, please.
I'm sorry.
Normal. I like German pornography.
I know. I was looking at you, and I wasn't getting normal. I wasn't getting normal at all. But
like
I want
German
to play along, because I kind of like you a little bit.
Nicole, they keep using this excuse, it's good to have, you know, diversity on campus so you can learn about other cultures. If you want about all the cultures, don't go to college, go to Epcot Center. You know what I mean? Come on. They act like white kids are gonna show up on the first day and be black guys in grass skirts chasing a gazelle through the student union with a knife. And Spanish students having cockfights in the basement of the dormitories.
Now, let me ask you this. Here's what's weird about the affirmative action thing is that the Asians don't get any points, you know? Because I guess they'd break, like, the thermometer on the whole thing.
Yeah, they don't get points. It's a billion of them.
I think they do get points. I think they get points.
They don't get points.
They get double points. They get miles. I think they get both.
And it says some Spanish get it and some don't. Now, that's kind of strange.
The non-entertainers.
It's really, they should all be getting about 60.
No, but I'm saying, isn't that kind of crazy? Like, the, you know...
But, you know, it's not just a 20-point system. The whole system is like 150 points.
Right.
You get a point for an essay.
I said Spanish essay.
Very cute. Thanks. That was nice.
You told me to set
that
you
was
up.
Good.
I set you up.
No, I said tell me to do Reagan.
It's very West Coast. That was
yeah, that was the West Coast.
That's very, very
that was in honor of La M.A., as they call it out there.
Did you say, though, Colin, when does the show start?
The show starts with...
We're going to a couple of weeks of warm-ups on the air. But let me ask you this. Go ahead.
One of the problems, the court is split, and they really have been.
When did you start reading?
It's like...
You don't even know the court was split in the NCAA tournament.
It was on tape.
No, he went to a site between, you know, dirty.com.
I happen to know this. Because they didn't want to talk about quotas, so of course they wanted to ask Sandra Day O'Connor and Ruth Bader Ginsburg, but neither one of them was available for comment because they had left the session early to make brownies and clean the toilets.
Did you just make a Ruth Bader Ginsburg joke?
I have to. I was obligated.
I thought it was going to be like a lesbian joke, and he was along with this.
No.
I know, he didn't work SARS or AIDS into that bit.
What about...
It was coming. That was part two.
Now, let me ask you this. The bottom line is, everybody says affirmative action, ideally, yes. Of course, everybody thinks it's a view, but would you, don't you think, if you really believe in affirmative action, you, as white males, I'll say, would give up your job right now? Because that's what you're asking other people to do, right?
No, that has nothing to do with it.
That's what you're asking. Males.
That has nothing to do with
it. We're not asking you. You're not a white male. You're a black woman. Relax.
I am a black woman. You're so good at this.
Thank you.
You just shut up on yourself.
Well, go ahead. But that's a good question.
Well, there was a discussion upstairs.
I ask a nice question.
But
I'm
the question
very proud.
You're asking, it sounds like
I say something intelligent.
It sounds like you're firing me, and I don't like that.
I think we've settled a lot of things here. Nobody likes Chris Webber, and forget. Thank God I didn't bring up Jalen Rose like I was gonna.
Can I ask you a question?
Wow. Go ahead.
What do you do when there's a lull on the show?
I'll tell you. That's, we use the popularity of The Daily Show. I run The Daily Show in the back on that during my show.
Is that true? What
so
time
people
is it
are
on?
Bored by my show, they can rewatch The Daily Show.
We don't mind if we go into a log because we're following you guys. You have like 11 people watching. Nobody's going to know. Well, yeah, I tried.
I know. Let me tell you people something.
I'm defending my boss.
Okay, well, I'll tell you the truth. Everybody knows you should get your job on merit. You ask anybody, how'd you get your job? They say, I knew somebody who got theirs on merit, and then they got me in. Come on, folks, that's a good one, and you know it. We'll be right back. Okay, now we all know New York City's been hurting for money since 9/11, yes? So recently, Mayor Bloomberg hired a chief marketing officer to find ways to franchise New York's name and the landmarks in the city. So tell me, as a fellow native of New York, is there anything wrong with that?
I don't think there's anything wrong with it. I think it's probably a good idea because you could sell off a lot of stuff. And I was thinking that maybe the NRA could buy the MTA. Yeah? And, you know, like, you have signs and stuff like that, like, guns don't kill people. That big fat lady taking up three seats kills people.
You have to pry my Metro card from my cold, dead hands. I know.
You know,
maybe you could get the Statue of Liberty to advertise douche products. Just because you're standing in water all day, there's no reason to smell like fish.
Now, let me ask you a question.
This side is a little crazy. What do you guys say?
Do they not crazy. Tell you the topics before the show? Is that...
No, I just started that.
I think it's a crime.
Head.
A crime. Oh, imagine heresy. Selling off the sponsorship of something as nice as the Chrysler Building.
That's a good point.
Yes. Imagine cheapening the Citibank Building with some sort of product placement. The whole city's a whore. Already.
There's better ways to raise money, man. Legalize drugs and tax them, man. You could wipe out the city deficit with one Friday night in Washington Square Park.
Amen.
Right? Come on. Let's get on it.
Wait, are we really seriously out of money?
Yes.
Yeah, which is amazing. We have a Jew running the city, and I can't believe that.
Well, he's got 4 million. 4 billion.
Billion. Billion. He's a billionaire.
I know. Let's hit him up for some.
I'm sorry. What does Goebbels say about other things?
He said, no, he just said a Jew runs the city.
If I say Jewish, would have been less offensive. Come on.
We've had a Jew running the city since it started. There was one.
You forget the guy before this guy, son?
You haven't heard the name Honeytown Nick?
But his name was, he was Italian, but his name started with Jew.
Rudy Giuliani.
Giuliani.
Hey, wait, that sounds like Professor Griff. Sorry, says the oldest man in the room. Anyway,
How the hell is that?
Because you said Jew, every name was
there. Professor Griff was kicked out.
Thanks. Anyway,
You listen to rap?
Hey, it's good to be here on VH1 Remembers. Now, look. But let me ask you this. What he's saying is true. The city, I go to the city now, TGIF, sunglasses. It's not like the city's distinctive anymore. Little Italy's a half a block long. You know, I mean, there's no, there really is no charm left in New York.
Why shouldn't they do it? I mean, sports does it, and they have no dignity about it. Every time there's a call to the bullpen, it's sponsored by an auto dealership, or the Yankees turn a Jiffy Lube double play, or Tyson's.
I used to live on 193rd Street in Broadway. That's the Dominican Republic.
Dominicano.
So, I mean, why not?
Yeah.
Now, can people come in and sponsor a whole area, like Chinatown? Could, like, Taiwan sponsor Chinatown and then do whatever they want with it?
Chinatown should be sponsored by Kleenex or gas masks.
But at what point does it become corruption? Now, this is going to sound like a made-up joke.
I think right away.
When Bloomberg does it.
It's going to sound like a made-up joke when I get it out. And, I really have to be a lot tougher on this show. This sounds like a joke, but it's not true. It is true. I was at St. Patrick's Cathedral last week, receiving Holy Communion, as is my wont.
You're kidding.
No, and I went in there. It was very, the Monsignor was there. And then as I go, he goes, body of Christ, I open my mouth. He goes, Nabisco. Come on, folks. I know it sounds like a joke, but this is what goes on.
Dude, if that's not your out, oh, that's got to be
that
your
should
out.
Be the out, but
it's throw
the
commercial.
Let's just keep,
let's just keep dwindling off into kind of a vague, you know, that's what the charm of the show is, apparently.
Let rich people, you know, give us money to put their names on things. Dick Cheney could put his name on the Holland Tunnel because, you know, it looks like one of his arteries at 5 o'clock on a Friday. I'm picking on a guy I like, and I'm still getting booed. Madonna, another tunnel.
There's nothing here in the city to
put a toll booth in front of her crotch. You know how many nickels?
Are we still making jokes about her being a slut?
Well, I am. Nobody's saying nothing, John. Like a, sitting there like a billion-dollar man.
Nikki, she's like a grandmother.
I mean,
isn't the sex thing over with her?
She's like a Madonna, if I can bring it back to
pretty like this to see if she's dead, baby.
All right, look.
She's pretty firm.
What about this? What if we start advertising, like, you know, those perp walks where they bring the guy down? You have, like, a mob guy advertise on his hand when he's putting his hand in front of the camera?
So they like Golden Palace?
I got cocky because of the, because of the other one.
Can I tell you something, honestly?
What was the punch to that?
Ooh, that was the punch to it.
Oh, well, I was sorry.
But luckily, he
said
Golden Palace. He tried to save me, but I was already on something else.
I thought it was a good one, boss.
Thanks, Arale.
What a bitch.
He looks like the younger brother in, like, the Mexican gang movie, you know? You're like, why are you doing
like the
this?
Chihuahua.
You joined a gang. Why is this night different from all other nights? Sound familiar, John? Because coming up, John and I will don our theologian caps.
Why not?
And compare and contrast Easter and Passover. Don't miss it.
Think you're tough enough? Then click on this.
We live in a country where people are afraid to say how they really feel.
Go to the Tough Crowd with Colin Quinn website at ComedyCentral.com and post your opinion on the message board. If it's tough enough, Colin just might respond to you on his show.
Shut up!
ComedyCentral.com. Speak now or forever hold your...
Well, John, because I love, because you love.
Stop.
You know what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
It's finally springtime. This is a great time for my religion because of Easter and John's religion because of Passover. So tonight I thought we'd compare our two holidays.
What a great exercise.
As in, well, exactly. Sounds good, though. Huh, John?
I think it sounds great, Carl. You know what? I'll read my answers off of the Jew cards. Let's do it.
You heard about the blind guy, right?
No.
I gave him matzah. He goes, who wrote this shit? No? As you know, John, Easter is when we celebrate Christ's resurrection. Because, you know, he died, right?
I'm familiar with that. You know, Passover is a holiday that...
And he didn't die of natural causes. Can we put it that way? Aware of that?
Yeah, I saw the movie. I know he didn't die of natural causes. Yeah.
It was a homicide, John. Let's face the facts. And do you know who killed him, John?
Telly Savalas.
No, played, guess again.
Playing Pontius Pilate.
Yeah. And then I
no.
No.
Rod Steiger?
I'll get
which movie do you want to go with?
I wanted to lose the movie.
Jesus, all
report.
Right.
I'll give you a hint.
Ben Him?
I'm sitting next to one.
Oh, a Jew. Jews did not kill Christ, my friend. He
lost the will to live.
We did not kill him. The Romans. The Romans, Colin.
Come on, John. Those guineas weren't smart enough to figure it out on their own. Somebody had to help them out.
What? So are we not talking about the holidays anymore? Or seriously, you're going to...
Sure.
You're going to put me down on the...
We're talking about how Jesus was resurrected, and we're talking about...
All right.
If it weren't for your people, maybe he wouldn't have been dead in the first place. That's all I'm saying.
Well, you know, at least my people can talk about their rabbis without having to use anatomically correct dolls. That's all I'm saying.
That's a good point. Good point.
All I'm saying is when you go into confession, you don't necessarily want the guy to go, oh, you think that's bad? You should hear what I did this weekend. That's all I'm saying. I had one in each hand. That's all I'm saying.
I admit, it's a little suspicious when the confessional booth has a glory hole. I'm not going to lie. But I'll say something else, John. The guy gives me 10 Hail Marys and 10 clang, 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 went to problems. That's a hand. But you don't think about it at the time. You know, you go on with your business and who knows? You're a kid, right? The bottom line is this, John.
What is the bottom line?
Is that I suppose you're right about my church. We do have some flaws, and your people are good at finding flaws, usually through a jeweler's eyepiece. That's
you know,
true, but...
I
wrote that one in 1937. I wrote that for a putsch speech outside of Bierbossen.
That was actually, that joke was in the Dead Sea Scrolls, oddly enough. They opened it up, translated, it was right in there. Seriously, though, you don't need an eyepiece, as I go back to the script. You don't need an eyepiece to see flaws like, I don't know, the Spanish Inquisition. I guess if the good word isn't good enough, you can always pull them apart using horses.
Oh, right, John. People. You know best, after all. You're the chosen people. Way to blend in with that nickname, by the way. But go ahead.
The thing is, it's hard to blend in when people are chasing you.
Oh, people are chasing you? John, let me ask you something. It's
yes.
One thing to say people
let
are chasing...
Let me ask you something. How do they edit this? No, let me ask you this. What is your part?
My part?
I don't know why we're fighting. I don't think. Because, listen, we're not even that religious. Let me tell you what I'm doing for Passover this year. I'm going to have a meatball parmesan from the nearby Bacon Shack. That's what I'm going to do.
I, myself, am not that religious either. Because,
really?
You know what I gave up for Lent?
What is that?
Catholicism. Now look.
So why are we fighting? Why not be friends? Why are we fighting?
Because you killed Christ. Happy Pesach.
Happy Easter.
John Stewart, everybody. We'll be right back. Thank you, Johnny. I'll tell you, folks, this has turned into a serious rank-out session. Folks, lots of places... That was me doing a character. Nothing? All right. ...have famous advertising slogans. A lot of places have them. Virginia is for lovers. Come, we have so much to show you in Jamaica. That's not the Jamaican one. Anyway, get your white ass out of Detroit or we'll cut you. I guess this was written before 8 Mile.
This is building.
Before 8 Mile, it must have been written. I mean, back in the 70s, New York's slogan was, I love New York. Now Mayor Bloomberg wants a new image for the city, so we need a new slogan and a commercial to go with it. John Stewart, would you like to start?
I wouldn't.
Oh.
But I will. I have two slogans.
That's that can-do attitude.
The first slogan is, New York, where the city has less money than the mayor. Or,
that's a good one.
Or,
that's a good one.
Here's my next slogan. I love new your name here. You know, I'm gonna sell it.
In retrospect, you'd flip those, right?
Yeah,
right,
probably
good.
End with the better one.
Ellen Cleghorn.
Thank you, Colin. My slogan would be, New York, we've got bridges. If you want to jump off a bridge, this is the place to be. Because we've got bridges. There's the Triborough Bridge, the Queensborough Bridge. The only bridge we don't have is Todd Bridges.
James Norton.
Well, I would do it where there's a picture of me on a packed subway car crammed up against a woman in front of me, smiling and waving at the camera. And the caption would be, New York, it's a great place to go out wearing sweatpants and no underwear.
Didn't they just change it to from Megan's Law to Norton's Law?
In honor. A great honor. You had a star put on the, well. All right, go ahead. Nick DiPaolo.
Thanks for saying my name. New York City, where diversity thrives. Then we cut to a Mexican immigrant getting on a German mountain bike to deliver a Sicilian pizza. On the way down Broadway, he cuts off an Iraqi cab driver who crashes into a Turkish falafel stand. Finally, he gets to the apartment where he's pistol whipped by two Crips after they find 85 cents worth of Canadian coins in his wallet.
All right. Now, here's why I usually wrap it up to a kind of, well, New York. This city's so filthy, the SARS virus can't even survive here. It had to buy a house in Westchester. It only comes in on weekends to go see a play from 1953 like Big River. That's our char, our show. If you'd like to see more jokes about branding, find a rodeo clown.
Good night.
It's the ultimate dating nightmare. He swore he'd never hook up with a girl like her.
Dude, she's awful.
And she'd never be caught dead with a pig like him.
He's nasty.
It's amazing how quickly 8 to 10 drinks will change their minds. This summer, it's the new dating show that proves standards go down as the blood alcohol level goes up. You choose the victims. We buy the drinks. They get it on. While You Were Drunk, the most intoxicating reality series ever.